So today is Today is May 12th. I am sick, so I'm home from work. I don't feel great. I took a COVID test. I am negative, which is great, but I feel like shit. This is a cold that's been going around. Ryan's mom was sick for like 3 weeks with it. She took multiple COVID tests. She never tested positive. She hasn't tested positive the whole time that there's been a pandemic, but I really don't feel good. It's geese. I love waking up to the sound of geese. I know everybody, a lot of people hate geese because they're mean, but like, so I'm like, so don't fuck with them. It's that easy. But I feel terrible. I think it's a head cold now that I've tested negative. I'll social distance. I'll wear a mask. I have medicine. Got my Vicks VapoRub. I got the greatest cough drops in the world. No, you cannot have these. And I have my DayQuil in the other room that I'm going to take in a minute. Because I do feel the pressure building right here. But it is a family tradition here on this channel, if you've been here since the beginning, to make videos while I'm sick. Because I have nothing else to do. And I can't go anywhere and I can't do anything. So, you know, Ricola used to have little messages in on their wrappers. I think they stopped doing that. Or this isn't the right one. But they used to have like little positive like things that they would say. And they don't anymore. It's like, what the fuck? Shit. Jesus Christ Almighty. But like I said, when I'm sick, I make videos because I have nothing else to do. I recently watched last week the 2016 Disney live action, The Jungle Book, which I've seen before. I saw it when it was new. You've seen one Jungle Book, you've pretty much seen them all. So I watched it again. And then I was like, wasn't there another one? It was Netflix with Warner Brothers. The Mowgli, the Jungle Book story, I forget, or something like that. Anyway, so I'm going to be referring to the Netflix one as Mowgli, and the Disney one is the Jungle Book. The one from Netflix was directed by Andy Serkis of Lord of the Rings fame, of 13 going on 30, and I think that's pretty much all he's done. No! Just kidding, I highly admire and love Andy Serkis. Caesar from the Planet of the Apes movies. And I have some feelings now that I've seen both of them. Why Andy? Why? I don't know. I just feel like, like I said, I love Andy Serkis. I respect him as a creator, as an actor. I think he should have won an Oscar numerous times at this point. And I see his vision. I see where he was going with Mowgli. There was just some things that I found pretty disturbing, honestly, that I didn't think were necessary, that I didn't think it was necessary to do what he did to the Jungle Book. And what I didn't know is that actually the Jungle Mowgli's story actually is only one story. I guess the Jungle Book is like numerous short stories. I thought it was just one because I knew we had it in the house, I'm pretty sure, the Jungle Book. And I'm pretty sure some of my siblings probably read some of the short stories, but I never, by the time I was old enough to read, I think the book that we had was probably destroyed at that point. Because we didn't have no Kindles back then. You got your hand-me-down shit. That usually looked like shit by the time you got it. And you're like, oh, thanks. The pages are just like falling out and there's boogers in them. And they're like ripped and there's someone drew something in them. Fucking hand-me-downs suck sometimes. Yes, I'm going to vape. Fuck off. But Andy, there's just some things you shouldn't do, boo. And like, again, I respect you so much. I really, really do. So that's why I'm sad that I didn't like it. I was expecting to watch Mowgli and really love it. And I think the casting is so spot on. I love Andy Serkis as Baloo and the way that his like his bottom teeth are like kind of uneven and it looks like he might have broken his jaw at one point and it kind of hangs down like that. Like I love the design. Christian Bale as Bagheera was, oh my God. I thought the Christian Bale Bagheera was better than the Ben Kingsley Bagheera. Thankfully, the portrayals are very, very different. So there is, I would have put Christian Bale's Bagheera into the Disney version and I would have put the Ben Kingsley one into the Netflix one. But I love Christian Bale. I thought he was great. I love the fight him and Baloo have in the Netflix one when they're arguing about like Mowgli and stuff like that. I think it's great. It genuinely feels like two friends just like pissed at each other. Whereas the Disney one, there really isn't much of a relationship to begin with. They just kind of start working together because they both care about Mowgli.
So why don't we all just have a little honey?
I don't eat honey.
I thought both boys, both young actors, did a phenomenal job regardless. I thought they were both cute in their own ways and they're both like just, I thought they both gave really sweet, very precious performances from this character. And I really, really cared about both of them. I don't like one more than the other. I think both young actors did a phenomenal fucking job. I think Jon Favreau did a great job, you know, with this kid who has nothing to act against. And that's really hard for an actor, let alone one that's so young. You know, in the Andy Serkis one, you can see that there's probably still sets, there's still obviously visual effects going on, but he's in like a real village. Like that's like looks like a real village that they built. In both versions, Ka is voiced by a female actor. In the Disney version, you have Scarlett Johansson, who's a much more menacing, but much smaller role. One scene. Much smaller role, far more menacing. She's going to eat Mowgli. She's gonna fucking eat him. In the Andy Serkis version on Netflix, you have Cate Blanchett, basically as Galadriel as a snake. I'm gonna be honest, she's basically Galadriel, but as a snake.
Boo! I'm flying!
But Cate Blanchett as Ka in the Netflix one has a lot more screen time, much more interesting screen presence, in my opinion. She actually got more to do with the character. You get the feeling that if she really wanted to, she would just swallow Mowgli whole, but she doesn't because she wants to see how his story plays out. In this version, everyone is afraid of Ka. Everyone is terrified of Ka. Everyone respects her and no one, like she's the real queen of the jungle.
Let the man come alone. He belongs to us.
And I really like that. I also really just, I love snakes, personally. I like that her voice also kind of sounded a little androgynous at times. I'm speaking of the Cate Blanchett portrayal. And very raspy. She sounds old. Like, Ka is supposed to be extremely old and she sounds ancient. But my biggest problem, honestly, was the violence. I just think that there's some things that don't need to happen. And I don't think a super violent Jungle Book was necessary, in my opinion. I just don't. That's me personally. I don't think it was necessary. I didn't think that we needed it necessarily. And I wouldn't watch it again. And let's come to the big one. So the final one, you know, the wolves are relatively mostly all the same. Akela still dies regardless. It just in a different way, but he still dies at the paws of Shere Khan. But let's talk about fucking Shere Khan for a second. Let's talk about it. So in the Disney version, you have Idris Elba voicing the role of Shere Khan, a very realistic looking tiger with some, you know, like liberties taken here and there. One of my favorite things about the portrayal of Shere Khan in the Disney version is that when he is approaching, you know he's coming before he's even there because of the vultures that follow him, which is actually true. A lot of scavenger animals follow predators around waiting for them to kill something so that they get a free meal. It's very common. But I like that. There's just something very ominous about it. I think Idris Elba's portrayal was very menacing. I mean, I think we've gotten to the point where I don't think we really need to portray certain types of animals as villains personally, because you know that animals don't hunt people. It's really silly. But it, you know, it's you have to have a villain, so let's make it the endangered species. Why don't we? I mean, I don't know if they were endangered by the time Rudyard Kipling came along and was writing these stories. Whatever. This isn't me standing on a conservation soapbox. Just please don't shoot animals, you fucking bastards. I prefer Idris Elba. I really don't like the design of Shere Khan in the Netflix version. I couldn't take it seriously. He was menacing, but not because of the way he looked. I did like that he had a limp, and I did read that in the story, Shere Khan did have like a gimpy, like, paw, basically, and it kind of scrapes along the ground. That's really interesting. I thought that was an interesting choice to make, because he's still very menacing. But there's something about the Benedict Cumberbatch portrayal that I felt very uncomfortable by. I felt very, very uncomfortable. I think Shere Khan in the Netflix Jungle Book, I think he comes across as a pedophile, quite frankly. I can't explain it. When the camera's on Shere Khan's face, and he is salivating, and he's just like dug his claws into Mowgli, like drags his claws down Mowgli's arm as Mowgli's unconscious, and now just thinking about it literally gives me the creeps. The camera cuts to Shere Khan's like face, and he's slowly leaning in. He's like, I'm just gonna try and insert a clip of it right here because I don't want to repeat it. He felt very pervy to me. The thing about Benedict Cumberbatch's villain voice is that it sounds the same no matter what. He sounded like Smog, but he was also panting a little bit more, and it sounded very wet. And I just couldn't take it seriously because I kept thinking, dude, you sound like a fucking pedo. I didn't like it very much. I didn't like it. And I thought he looked stupid. I thought the design was terrible. I was like, I should have just gone with a realistic looking tiger. I'll try and throw it up on the screen. Look at the Idris Elba one. Look at the Benedict Cumberbatch one. One of these looks stupid. And it's not the Disney one. I wasn't planning on making a video today because I didn't know I'd be sick and feeling like absolute trash. Like, and thankfully I don't have COVID. This has just been me talking and comparing like the two films. I prefer the Disney one. Sorry, Andy. I think you're a phenomenal filmmaker. And I see where he was going with it. It's not that I can't see his vision. It's that I didn't think it was necessary. And I didn't think that, I don't think injecting violence into beloved children's stories that are already pretty dark thematically already is all that necessary. Sometimes it's just a story. Sometimes it's just a kid's story. Sometimes we don't need to keep injecting more violence or gratuitous torture on a child. Like, Shere Khan's torturing Mowgli, and I don't like that. I don't like that.
So much more to come.
I just, maybe it's because I spend more time around children now and I understand their fears and things of that nature, and I understand that they don't understand what a predator is, that made the Mowgli one just, I just couldn't watch that. I just couldn't watch it. Especially when Shere Khan's just like standing over him and is just going, it's just disturbing to me, and I didn't like it. That's all I've got. And again, Benedict Cumberbatch's villain voice is the same for every character. He's a phenomenal actor. I think he deserves all the praise that he gets. But he basically plays the same villain every time. And that's how I feel about it. Thank you for watching. Live long and prosper. Peace and long life. And stay tuned to Turn On for more. Please stay safe. Please stay masked. Please get vaxxed. And please get tested if you think you're sick. I did, and it was super easy. Bye.